Hi, and welcome back to Tech Talk. I'm Ken Mingus, Executive Editor at Computer World. I'm here with J.R. Raphael, our Android expert. We're going to be talking about Android 10 and focusing on gestures and what the hell's going on this year. Stick around. Okay, so J.R., thanks for being here, man.
Hey, thanks for having me. Good to be here.
It's good to have you back.
Yeah.
Obviously, Android 10 is out now. And as you've written about several times on Computer World, you know, one of the big changes is gestures.
Yes,
big and there's change. There's this big debate, you know, that goes on, and you know, we're going to deal with this in a future episode about, you know, who comes up with gestures and who can improve them and who adopts them and who copies them and all that. But I wanted to get a sense from you about especially Android 10, what's changed, because as I recall, one of the things that happened was that with the last version of Android, we got new gestures. And then with Android 10, we got revamped gestures.
Right.
Which is going to mean a lot of Android users have to redo some muscle memory really quick.
Yeah. A lot of change, a lot of adjustment. And if you've been following along, anyone who watches the betas of Android 10, the public betas that Google puts out, there have been a lot of little steps along the way where things have evolved. So especially if you're really tuned into Android news, there's been a lot of little changes in evolution. Android 9, which still had a name, was known as Pi, unlike Android 10.
I know, I kind of missed the naming convention.
Yeah,
Android 10 just sounds so Apple-like in some ways, and not in a good way. It's like,
anyway. It lost the whimsy.
Yeah.
It'll always be queen of puddings.
There you go.
Yeah.
I'm Android quiche. I know it's not sweet, but it's the only thing I can come up with.
Could
a
be.
Few.
Put a little sugar on top.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah,
okay.
Yeah.
But anyway, gestures. All right. So Pi.
So Pi kind of introduced this hybrid system where they were testing the waters. There was still a back button that would appear on the screen.
A
when
physical
it was
button or okay,
an on-screen button,
virtual button. Okay.
Yeah, but it would appear as needed, an actual tappable, dedicated button, and it wouldn't always be there. Like on your home screen, you wouldn't see it, but when you opened up your browser, or you opened up Gmail or whatever app, it would pop up when relevant.
Yep.
And then there was kind of like a pill, one button in the middle that was the home button. You could tap it
every time you hit
you
that.
Could swipe
back to
it
home.
In different ways. So it was kind of like a mashup. It was gestures. It was also traditional buttons. A little bit of both.
Mm-hmm.
It was a little. It was awkward. It was kind of like they were trying to do gestures without.
Really, without really
going
committing
to it, exactly.
Yeah. Yeah.
And so Android 10 completely reinvents the wheel with that, taking a model that, as we've talked about a lot, is much more similar to Apple's iOS gesture model. Not exactly the same, but it definitely has. There's undoubtedly some overlap. So you know now there is no actual button. You have a little kind of line on the bottom of the screen, and you can swipe up on it to go home. You swipe up and hold to get to your overview, your recent apps to move between apps. You can swipe left or right on it to move between recent apps. And then instead of a back button, you now can just swipe in from the left or right side of the screen anywhere to go
this
back.
This doesn't sound to me, and you know, again, coming from the Apple side of things where there have been a variety of gestures and changes over the years. I know that you know Apple did some changes last year in 2018. And you know, it really does require learning new ways of navigating your phone. You don't really think about it because you know you get so used to you know swiping and swiping up, swiping down.
Mm-hmm.
How is someone, say, coming to Android 10 for the first time supposed to know what these new gestures are? Is it spelled out in a way that makes it clear what you want to do if you want to go back or go to your home screen, or you just need to read up on it, or how does a user know that?
That's a good question. I think we'll have to see because it'll be up to each device.
I mean, I realize most people probably haven't even gotten Android 10 yet.
Right. And to its credit, what Google seems to be doing, and I think what most device makers will probably do, is leave the gestures off by default if your device didn't have them to begin with. So, you know, if you're using a phone that has the old three buttons on it, if you upgrade to Android 10, whenever you get that upgrade, you would be able to turn them on in the settings. But by default, it's not going to be there. That said, of course, when we start seeing new phones come out with Android 10, they will presumably more and more have them enabled. The one phone that I've seen that does have them enabled by default, which was the new OnePlus 7T phone, it did do a nice little tutorial when you first start up and you could select between traditional buttons or the gestures.
Mm-hmm.
And then when you went to gestures, it would tell you, swipe up here to go home, swipe up here and hold. And it kind of walked you through a little tutorial of doing it. And I think that's going to be key because it really is an adjustment, like you said.
Mm-hmm.
And I think the first day or two of anyone using it, you're going to be a little, you just feel out of sorts, like you don't know where you are. It's such a key part of the phone experience.
Well, speaking of out of sorts, we were talking with video producer Chris here, who was not amused. He's an Android guy. Not amused with the change in the gestures because he thinks they're too reminiscent of Apple. And, would you say that that's the case? Do you find that the gestures that Android 10 now has are more iOS-like they really have adopted whatever Apple was doing?
Yeah, I mean, by and large, I don't think it's not identical. There are areas that are different. Like in iOS, you don't have the universal swipe in back thing because back has never been kind of as prominent in iOS as it is in Android. But yeah, I mean, at its core, there's certainly a lot of overlap, and it's hard to deny that they took some inspiration from that, you know, sort of in the way it works and treating it as a standard. So, you know, for me, when I first went to it, I think I had a day where I had just felt discombobulated and I wasn't quite sure. And I said, I don't know. And to be fair, too, that wasn't an early beta when I was using it. It's gotten a lot better along the way. And I think once most people give it, you really have to go to a solid few days to a week. I think most people.
You had said earlier about a week. So give it a week and you should be good to go. If you can't figure it out after a week, you may want to, you know, rethink this whole gesture thing.
Yeah. But the nice thing is Google is leaving in the old three button traditional Android setup as an option. When Pi came around, that wasn't an option. People were upset, both people who just preferred that, and then for, you know, accessibility purposes, some people have a harder time with gestures and with tapping. So from here on out, Google has mandated that every device has the option to go back to the old three button kind of style.
For those who want to live a more analog life, yes, as indeed. I say,
always there.
You had written last week that you know, with the gestures and things, that you there are still two what you call fatal flaws, or at least serious issues with what's going on. So what was that about?
Yeah, so a lot of the things I wrote about early on in the early betas have been addressed, and things have definitely been smoothed out and gotten better. But there are really two big lingering flaws that, having used this final version of the Android 10 gestures for a while, just keep jumping out at me. And the first is consistency, where there – and it mostly ties to that back command, the swiping in. And what people find a little weird, too, you can swipe in from the left or the right, and that's both back.
Either way, right, to go back?
Yeah, you would logically think the right would be a forward.
Yeah.
But the idea is that there has never been a forward command in Android. It's always to go back. And for, you know, whatever way you're holding your phone, left or right-handed, holding your left hand, your right hand, there's always a simple way to do it that's easy to access.
Is that why it's done? So if you're a lefty, you can swipe, or if you're, you know, either way?
Yeah. Some Googler said that at some point in, I think maybe it was at I.O. or in some Q&A, they said that it was kind of for accessibility reasons and to make it easy to hold in either hand.
Okay.
But still, the problem with that gesture is it kind of overlaps and conflicts with a lot of other existing commands within Android. So some of the examples I gave, when you're swiping in Google Photos, you might pull up your phone and you'd be swiping between images in your gallery. Yeah. Well, that's sort of that same exact swiping mechanism.
Yeah.
And often I'll be flipping through images and accidentally go back and get taken back out to, you know, the main view instead of being in Photos.
When that happens and you go back to Photos, does it at least take you back to where you were in Photos, or do you have to go back, or does it take you back to the starting point in Photos?
It'll take you back to like the main photo screen. So if you're looking through, say, an album.
So you've gone through 100 photos and you accidentally hit back and then you go back to Photos, you got to go through those 100 photos again?
Well, it'll take you back to whatever screen you were most recently on.
Okay.
But it's still irritating. And so the proper procedure is to scream and yell and curse and stomp your feet and that kind of stuff. And it's not the only place. Like in, if you do any kind of photo editing, sometimes I use an app called AZ Screen Recorder to take some of the, you know, screen video casts that show up in my stories.
Mm-hmm.
And in that too, there's a little swipeable tool, and you're moving through the timeline, and suddenly you go slightly too far to the edge, and you've been taken. You take yourself back. And if an app doesn't have a confirmation, do you wish to go back? You could potentially lose what you're trying to do.
Is the assumption there that application developers, you know, as these gestures become more prominent or more common, that the app developers themselves are going to tweak the apps so that you would avoid situations like that? I mean, is it up to the, I guess it's up to the app developer.
Yeah, right? And I think that's kind of the problem, is that's the assumption, but Google needs to set a standard and make it clear and make it consistent. Because right now, I mean, the truth is a lot of the apps that are problematic are Google's own apps, which really tells you a lot. Yeah.
That's weird.
It
Why would
weird.
They not coordinate on that?
That's a question.
Okay. Why would you not coordinate
Google.
On that?
Yeah. I mean, even Gmail, you can swipe away messages. You know, if you want to archive a message, you swipe it in the Google's own messaging app, you swipe away messages to dismiss them.
Yep.
But a lot of apps use that gesture. And I think the idea in theory is that you do a slightly different kind of swipe for one or the other, but it's just you don't get that consistency and you never know what's going to happen. And, you know, in Gmail, sometimes I've tried to swipe back to go out of the app to my home screen and, whoops, I accidentally archived a whole message.
An important email that you needed to hang on to.
Right.
Which is still there, but it's archived now.
Right. And if you don't see it, you know, in the 5 or 7 or however many seconds you have to hit that undo button, then that happened to me once where I said, well, I have no idea what I just archived away.
Where it went,
that was your email, I apologize. Yeah. I don't know who's it
was. Now you know what happened.
my permanent excuse for the next 10 years that I just accidentally swiped it away. Maybe it's a good thing. It'll give us an excuse.
All right, so consistency is an issue. Yeah. And then you had also written about commitment.
Yeah, and that kind of is that same thing. Most of it revolves around that back gesture. A pretty common swiping pattern in Android is swiping in from the left side of an app to open its main menu. They're called navigation drawers.
Like a drawer. Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. And again, swiping in from the left side of the screen, just like the back. So Google tried to kind of make a compromise and let both things exist in a weird way with just slight variations. Like they have this gesture that what they call peaking, where you slide in, but you don't just swipe in like you're going back. You slide in and kind of stop a little
yeah.
and then you keep going. But it's just, you never know what you're going to get when you do that. And so there too, it's just like we need to just commit to it and say, this is now the system back gesture. We don't have other commands that do that. If you want to open the navigation drawer, you can tap this or slide in with, you know, two
or maybe have a slide at the top to open the drawer and a slide from the bottom to go back or something like that. Something that's very discreet and you know it's either or. It's not kind of in between.
Right, right. And it gets even more muddled. Google actually went and added a setting, if you kind of dig through Android settings, for the back gesture sensitivity. So you can adjust and say, you know, I want to open my app drawers more often, and this is so I'm going to make it less sensitive. But you shouldn't have to do that with a basic, you know, system command. And it, even with that, it still doesn't quite get you that knowing for sure what you're going to get. So Google needs to really commit to it and say, this is the new gesture. We're going to reserve this area of the screen. This kind of swiping is for Android's back command. And developers, if you want your apps to work on Android 10, you're going to have to not interfere with that.
Right. Any sense, and I know obviously it's very premature, but is there any sense at all that with Android 11 we might get revamped gestures again?
It's Google.
Make three in a row?
Yeah.
There's no way to know, right?
You never know. You never know. I'm sure they'll refine it. Hopefully they won't reinvent the wheel again, but it's Google. I mean, how many times have we seen in the past where something, they're all in on something, and then a year
suddenly
later,
they're not. It's gone.
It's deleted. So, yeah, you never know.
Okay. Any final gestures you'd like to offer Google before we let you go?
Well, I won't do one that would get us taken off.
Yeah,
there,
no,
it's really not that bad. The whole system has come a long way. I think it just needs a little more refinement, probably that ideally should have been done before this came out, but still, maybe 10.1, we'll have the answer and we'll clean things up a little. Yeah. It's tough because Android's an open ecosystem. There's so many people, players, every manufacturer kind of does their own take on it. Of course, like with iOS, there are a lot of apps out there. But at a certain point, Google's got to kind of stand up and take control and say, this is how we're doing it. Everybody needs to get in line. You know, much we talk about borrowing a page from Apple's playbook. Apple certainly knows how to control
people.
This is
it. And you will work with our system as we've got it, and or you won't.
Yeah.
In which case your app won't work right.
There's probably a happy medium between those two, but Google needs to get a little more firm and get app developers to stand up to it.
Commitment. We're looking for it, Google. When it comes to gestures, commit. Great. Okay. Thank you so much for the details. Now, I do understand kind of what's going on in the Android world with gestures. It sounds like, as with everything, practice will make perfect. Give it a week if you're new to Android 10, and see how it goes. Thanks, JR. I appreciate it.
Yeah, thanks for doing it.
Again, if you're watching us on YouTube, just a reminder to please subscribe to the channel. If you've got questions or even comments, leave them in the comments field below. We'll take a look and see if we can answer them. And in the meantime, for now, that's a wrap. Thanks, JR.
Thanks.